the substructure, superstructure. Suppose this is a small building. This is a small building. This building we are observe above the ground level. We will observe this building above the ground level. So the portion of the building which lie above the ground level is considered as a superstructure. It's considered as superstructure. Now, as this superstructure hold by some part of the foundation which actually anchor down the structure below the ground level into the soil, that is called as the substructure. Now here, this superstructure is being supported with the help of the foundation. And this is the part of the footing, or this is basically the superstructure. This is basically the substructure. And this substructure is further known as foundation. This substructure is further known as foundation. So what is the purpose of the foundation? Purpose of the foundation to anchor down the structure into the soil, so that it will provide additional stability to the structure. Because what is the purpose of the foundation? Just to anchor down the structure into the soil so that it will be stable in the lateral position. Secondly, it is mostly used to transfer the load of the superstructure to the hard strata, and it will be just to provide a uniform base for the superstructure. So this is superstructure and this is the substructure. Now substructure is called as foundation. Foundation is the integral part of the structure which actually providing stabilities to the structure, increase, transfer the load of the structure to the hard strata. So what is our basic aim? Basic aim is to rest the foundation over the hard soil. Rest the solid foundation on a good quality soil. Good quality soil. Why we are taking it over the good quality soil? So that it will provide a better resistance. It will provide a better resistance. Whatever load is expected to come over the soil, it provide a better resistance from the opposite side so that your structure is in a stable condition. Right? So here, we will just rest the foundation on a good quality soil or on a soft, on a steep soil. Basically, this is the part of the foundation. It's further divided into two types. One is shallow foundation and another is deep foundation. Now, what is this shallow and deep foundation? It is completely depends upon the depth of the foundation. When D is less than its B. Now suppose here, this is B, that is the depth of the foundation, and this is B, that is the width of the foundation or the breadth of the foundation. So this B and B, if suppose this B is less than B, in this case, it will be called as shallow foundation. And then this B is greater than, largely depends upon the B, then it will be called as deep foundation. Now where we will suggest the shallow foundation? Well, the load coming over the structure is less or light. Structural load is less. Well, we will suggest the shallow foundation when the structural load is less. Load is less. Then second, load is even, not subjected to lateral load. And a very important is when the load is relatively less, and the secondly, the very important parameter, when steep to hard strata is at shallow. Steep to hard strata is available at a shallow depth. If you will found a good quality of sound soil is at the shallow depth, which is able to resist the load which is coming for the super, from the superstructure, naturally there is no need to go deeper and deeper. When your depth of the foundation is increases, your depth of the foundation is increases naturally, or ultimately the construction cost of the foundation is increased. It is inversely proportional. It is directly proportional. When we will increase the depth, the ultimate cost of the foundation is increased. Right? So base and the very important is when the structural load is less and the steel and the very good quality of soil is available at a shallow depth, then we will go for the shallow foundation. What are the different types of the shallow foundation? The types of the shallow foundation is strip footing, then isolated footing. That isolated footing may be a circular, it may be a rectangular, it may be a square, or it may be of any shape. Then the second one is combined footing. Then is a strap footing. And lastly, there is a mat footing. This is the mat footing. So these are the types of the footing where left is very less as compared to is B, then it is called as the shallow footing. Then further, when depth is more, adverse will be the condition. Here, when the structural load is more, load is not even not subjected to, or it is subjected to lateral stresses, and the very important that if the steel and the hard strata is not available at a shallow depth, in that case we will go for the deep. Right? So the conditions are adversely different. Here we can say that load is high, then second, load is not, or load is uneven, subjected to differential settlement, then subjected to lateral stresses, subjected to lateral load, and very important, subjected to lateral load, and the very important is if the hard strata are not available at a shallow depth. Here, if the hard strata is not available at shallow depth, then we will go for the deep foundation. I think this is clear for you. When the load coming over the structure is not even, more load is there, the stresses, that is lateral stresses, are there, and the very important, when the load, when the at which the foundation is resting, that soil is not enough to take that load, or not strong enough to take that load, in that case we will go for the deep foundation. I think this part is clear to you all. Now we will just see the diagrammatical representation of the things. Here, we will just consider, this is the same property. Here, there is a ground level. This is ground level. This is the small residential building. This is the small residential building. Small building. And here, the strata is available at grade level. Here, this is the soft soil. And this is also the soft soil. And this is the hard or the firm soil. Here there is a small building, and here we will assume that there is a multi-story construction. There is a multi-story construction constructed at a particular location. As it is the same profile all over, here naturally this is the small residential building, so the load expected to come over the foundation is less. Load coming over the foundation is less, and therefore here we can go for the shallow footing. If suppose the same soil profile is available over there, but the load coming over this is very high, Q is less, and here this Q is maximum or high. This Q is high. So in such cases, we do not have the option to place the foundation on a soft soil. In that case, we will go deeper. We will rest the foundation over the hard strata, and suppose this depth is assumed to be 1.5 and this depth is again 1.5 and this depth is assumed to be 6 meter. This depth is assumed to be 6 meter where the hard strata is lying. We are trying to rest the foundation over the hard strata. Now just remember, just think on it, whether we will just extend such type of footing up to a depth of 6 meter. If suppose we will extend such type of footing up to a depth of 6 meter, so we will just go like this. And we will place the foundation. So this is not suggested to use. This is not economical one to extend a footing up to a depth of 6 meter. And therefore, we will go for the another option that is called as the pile foundation. Here, we will go for the option deep foundation, and there are three types of deep foundation. Now again, I will remove the diagram. Here, what we will do, I will just talk about the pile foundation. In this case, what I will do, I will just insert a small slender structural members. We will insert a small structural neighbors, which are small and clean structural members. These are the clean structural members which we will extend into the soil up to a deeper depth. We will rest these all slender members, just similar to this. These are the very small cross-sectional area slender structural member which we will just arrange in a square pattern or in a rectangular pattern depending upon the structure. And then the small clean members will be penetrated into the soil, and that members will reach to the hard strata. That members will reach to the hard strata, and then the whole member will take a look. So what is that? There is a number of piles and the soil which is surrounded by the pile which is surrounded by the soil. So here, this surrounded soil and pile is considered to be a single member, and it will be act as a group. And all the members are further connected with the help of a pile gap, then it is called as pile. You can see this is the small section. This is the model which we have created into the laboratory. You can see this is the small member. Here, you can see this is the small member. These small members are penetrated into the soil at a specified dimensions and specified spacing. And then, all piles are being connected with the help of a pile gap at its top. You can see this is the complete pile group. There are 9 piles which are arranged in a square pattern. 3, 3, 3. Then all these 9 piles are inserted into the soil, and further all the piles are connected with the help of a pile group. Then the whole member will be act as a single pier, and that pier will take a mold. Right? So this is the concept of pile foundation. Instead of providing a huge open foundation up to a depth of 6 to 7 to 10 meters, that may not be an economical solution. In that case, we will provide a small and clean members. We will just insert the clean members at a required area, and then whole it is connected with the help of a pile gap, and then it will be completely act as a single member which can take more. That is basically the concept of the pile foundation. Then further, these deep foundations are again divided into three types. This deep foundation is again divided into three piles or three types, that is deep foundation, it is first pile foundation, then another is pier foundation, and the next one is bell foundation. So these are the three types of foundation, where this bell foundation is the open caisson. This is the open caisson. This open cast iron is well known with the name well foundation in India. Now, what is meant by pile? Piles are the slender structural member. It is very thin, slender structural member like this, which is always inserted in a groove. Then there will be a pier. What is meant by pier? Pier is having larger cross section area. Larger cross section area as compared to pile, length is more. This is pier. And the third one is well foundation. Which is commonly known as open cast iron. Now this is the well foundation which is having open Now just think on it. Here the length is large. Here this is the thin member. Cross sectional area is very less as compared to its depth. Therefore, always is inserted in the wood. And there the whole group will be act as a single pier. Now here, cross-sectional area is very less. In this case, cross-sectional area is more or large. Now here we will suggest these two types. When the piles are or the grain is going to be transferred through a soil, always remember that when the load is to be transferred through a soil, then the pile and the surrounding soil will be act as a single pier which can take more. Right? So here this is always inserted in a group and cup movement, then load is to be transferred through soil. Here load. Load is transferred through soil. Because the soil won't act as a single member. We just hold the material together and then it will be act as a single member that we have discussed, right? Here, in between these piles, there is a soil. Now just remember that if such pile will be inserted into the water, what will happen? Naturally there is no support of the soil, and in that case there is a chance of the floating of this pile. Because there is a wave pressure on the lateral dimensions and buoyancy force acting in the upward direction. Seepage pressure, buoyancy force which are acting in the upward direction. So in such cases we want the self weight of the foundation is more. And here, when the pier foundation are used, where load, load is to be transferred through water. Here we can use the foundation when the it is transferred through the soil. But when there is a water, naturally there is a buoyancy force, and due to that we want the self weight of the foundation is more. So here self weight is more. In both these cases, Now if the self weight is more and if it is constructed with the massive concrete, then it is not an economical one. Because the whole section is completely constructed with the help of a concrete, and in such cases it may not provide you an economical solution, but it will provide a stability. When it is to be inserted through a deep water, right? Then if suppose here this option is not suitable, This option is not suitable due to not economical section. This is, suppose I will consider this is the pipe. If suppose this is the pipe, then this section I will consider as a pier. You can see this is pipe. Pipe is a slender member, cross sectional area is less, and pier is the larger cross section, but the length is more. But this may not be economical. So we will go for the third option, that is called as well formation. In the well formation, here this is the massive structure. The whole it is constructed with the help of concrete, and concreting is a very costly method where it may not provide the economical solution, but you have to increase the water cell weight so that it can be stable in the buoyancy force when there is a buoyancy force or there is a natural wave pressure. In all the cases, it should be provide a stable support to the formation. In that case, we will go for the third option, that is called as well formation. Now, what is meant by well formation? Well formation is an open well, open cascade. You can see this is the small section of the, this is the small section of the well formation. Suppose this is the hollow well, which is open at the bottom as well as the top. But here you can see this is the cross sectional area of the pier, and this is the cross sectional area of the pipe. Here this is the hollow well, hollow, circular, rectangular, it may be square, it may be octagonal, it may be hexagonal, depending upon the different types of the shape. But we will just talk about the circular well. There this is the hollow well. Now here this hollow well, which are constructed with the help of RCC or it is with the help of masonry. Then that hollow well is constructed over the casting yard and transported over the river bank. Then further river bank or Kahikarti, then further it is transported from the river bank to the deep water and placed over the required position because it is having the cutting edges at its bottom. It is having the cutting edges at its bottom. Then further it is placed over the exact surface and sink it by giving the pressure. Sink it into a firm stratum. Sink it into a firm stratum up to certain depth. Once it is placed at its required position, then the concreting is made over here. Concreting is made over here. This is called as bottom plug. Plug it just bottom of the well. Here suppose this is the open well, then when it is placed at the required surface, then the concrete is poured into the well, and it, which will plug the bottom. Bottom air is plugged, then the water from the well is removed. Water, first the water is removed from the well, then the bottom concreting is made at the bottom so that the bottom side of the well is plugged, so that there will not be any entry of the moisture or water into the well. Further, the sand is filled into this. Once the sand is completely filled up to the top, then again at the top also the plug is made. Here, that is top plug. This plug is actually the concreting which is made at the top so that the whole complete will be in an intact position because it is directly coming in contact with the bottom. So bottom is plugged, top is plugged, and internal part is filled with the poor quality or any type of the sand. Further, the cap is provided and then the pier of the hole or the pier is laid above it. Right? Now what is the purpose? It can take more load. It provides better stability and it is economical also. Understand the concept? Here, this pile is suitable only when there is a, the load is to be transferred to the soil, because the pile root and the surrounding soil will act as a single member which will take more. The second one, when the load is to be transferred to a deep water, these may not provide you the better solution because there is a chances of the buoyancy force which is coming in the upward direction and the lateral pressure which will just reduces the stability of the pipe. In that case, we will go for the pier formation. Pier is the massive concrete member which is having larger cross-section area as compared to pile. It provides better stability and strength to the structure, but it is not economical. Further, when we will go for the well foundation, here the open well, where the open clean wall well is being constructed over the casting yard, transported over the required position, sink it up to a certain depth, then the concreting is made at the bottom just to plug the bottom surface, then the sand is filled into this, and further again it is filled with the concrete at the bottom. And then the concrete, the pile cap is placed above that, the loading is made. So this is economical as well as provides more stability to the structure. So this is about all the deep foundation. Now I think the concept of the deep foundation is clear for you. Now further we will just focus on the pile foundation, because pile foundation is actually the part of your slabs. Now we will just come to the presentation part. You focused on the presentation. सर ये कर लीजिएगा, हाँ. So now we will discuss about the pile foundation. So as we already discussed about the pile foundation, piles are the slender structural member, circular or rectangular in section, constructed with concrete, it may be a precast concrete or it may be a timber or composite piles. Now these are the pile types of the deep foundation: pier foundation, well foundation and pile foundation. So cations are the name which is commonly used in out of India, where open cations are mainly called as well foundation in India. Here you can see these things we have already discussed. The mostly the functions of pile to transmit the load of the superstructure to the solid or the strong ground, then to resist the vertical as well as lateral as well as uplift stresses. If the soil immediately beneath its base does not have adequate bearing capacity, when the load on the foundation is irregular and subjected to unequal settlement, when the load have to be transferred through a deep water and soil is subjected to erosion and scoring, then we will go for the type of deep foundation. Now this is the most important part. Next is the classification of the pile. So all we know, firstly the piles are being classified on the basis of material used. What are the different materials which are used in ancient period? As we all know, before the invention of the concrete, the people are using timber as a construction material mostly, because that time it was available in very cheap and in ample quantity it was available. So timber is basically used when in ancient days. Further, steel has taken the place of the timber because timber is having their number of disadvantages, because it is a small thin section of steel provides better strength as compared to a larger section of timber. So the sectional cross-sectional area is less and the strength is more, and here the timber is subjected to deterioration, or it may be decomposed after a certain period and strength is lost. Then further, when there was an invention of the concrete piles are most commonly used everywhere in the construction. That concrete piles may be a precast piles or in a cast in situ piles. Precast pile means the piles which are constructed over the casting yard and directly obtained over the site and installed. And cast in situ piles are the piles which are actually casted over the site itself. And the next one is the composite piles. Composite piles mean the combination of one or two or three material which will very rarely use, because where there is a connection of the two dissimilar material, the weak section is becomes weaker. Therefore, this is not more recommended piles. Then the next important is classification based on method of installation. So first is the driven pile.
then driven and castellan citopile board. So out of that, first we will discuss the driven pile. Here you can see these are the driven piles. Now what is mean by driven pile? These piles which are drive into the soil with the help of a hammers. Now just all of you remember, this is the name. All of you, everyone knows about the nail. Suppose this is the nail section, this is the small nail. This nail is a precast nail because we are not casting it. We are just obtaining it from the market and we are just penetrating it into the soil. Now what is the procedure to penetrate this pile into the wall? We are just hammering it at the top and then we are penetrating it into the soil. How the load is acting? The loading is dynamic. Jitna force zyada, utna penetration zyada. So here, this is the called as the driven piles, or this is the driving method. In this case, these are the precast pile. Precast pile which are casted over some casting yard, directly transported from the casting yard to the required position, placed on its required position and hammered it at the top with the help of a hammer. Then it is called as driven pile. All the precast piles are the driven piles. These piles are driven into the soil by applying blows of heavy hammers on their top. So this is the soft ground, this is the hard ground, this is the first position. Further, it is installed with the help of a very heavy hammers which are operated by the cranes and machineries, and then it is being installed. Once the first is installed, then side by side another 4, 5 and whatever group piles are installed, and then all the installed piles are combinedly binded together with the help of a pile cap. So these are called as driven pile. Then the another type of pile is the driven and cast in situ pile. Here second pile is a, we can say this is driven and cast in situ pile. Means the pile is casted over the casting yard. It is not transported by anywhere else. Now here the borehole is made. What is borehole? Borehole is made with the help of these boring augers. You can see these type of augers are being used over the field, which is having the threads, and whatever is the diameter of this thread will make the hole of that particular site. So first borehole is made with the required dimension, that is diameter and length. So this is the driving hole is drive with the help of an auger and the casing is inserted. What is mean by casing? You can see this is the casing, that is the hollow circular pipe which is inserted into the borehole so that the surrounding material will not fall into the hole, and the complete construction is made into a dry or in an intact stage, right? So casing is further inserted. Once the casing is inserted, if it is a RCC pile, then the reinforcement cage is inserted over here and further the concreting is done. So this pile is called as the bored and cast in situ pile. These piles are called as bored and cast in situ pile. But when it will be a driven pile? When the driving is made at the top. Driving means what? The hammering is made at the top and simultaneously the hammering is made and concrete is just enlarging at the bottom. Concrete is enlarging at the bottom and simultaneously the casing is removed. You can see this yellow arrows are showing that the casing is lifted up. Simultaneously the casing is lifted up and the concrete is dried with the help of the hammer so that there may be an enlarged base is formed at the bottom, which are the special types of driven piles which create a bulk or the enlarged cross section at the bottom so that it provide an additional anchorage to the structure. So these are the driven and cast in situ pile. These piles are formed by driving a casing with closed bottom end into the soil. And further, what is meant by cast in situ piles? Bored and cast in. Third pipe is bored and cast in situ pile, where bored piles boring is made, the reinforcement cage is inserted and the concreting is made. No hammering. no hammering is there, in that case it is called as a bored and casting situ pile. So these are the three types of pile. Then the third is a screwed pile. Third type of piles are the screwed pile. What is the difference between the nail and the screw? Nail is having a plain surface, where screw is having a threads on its surface. Same is the case, the threads are made into the pile and it is just penetrated into the soil by the with the help of the threads which are made over the pile. And the last one is the jagged pile. Jagged pile, and what is the difference between the jagged pile and driven pile? In the driven pile, we are hammering it at the top. These are called as driven piles. And then the static load is given with the help of a hydraulic jack. Static loading is given with the help of a hydraulic jack, where the loading is static, then in that case it is called as jagged piles. Right? So these are the classification based on the method of installation. Now the next classification is classification based on the load transfer mechanism. Classification based on mode of transfer of load. We all know in the previous section we have discussed that the load is transferred to the hard strata. That is why we are resting the foundation on the hard strata. We are resting the foundation on a hard strata. So here, this first pile is called as end bearing pile, where the piles are raised over the hard strata. In that case, this QP is the resistance which is given by the harder soil and which is acting over the cross-sectional area of the pile. Then it is called as the end bearing pile. Many times, if the hard soil is at a very large depth, suppose this is the pile and hard strata is at a large depth. In that case, we will never extend the foundation up to a hard strata. We will just place it up to a certain depth and then leave it. In that case, what will take the load? Here, this is the pile and this is the surrounding soil. You just see the action. This is a surrounding soil. There, if suppose I will apply the load, in that case, the frictional force is developed over the periphery due to the surrounding soil, and that is called as frictional force. So here, when the piles not reaches up to the hard strata, in that case the load is taken by the frictional resistance which are developed over the periphery. And the third is the combined piles, where both the actions, that is it is rested over the hard strata, simultaneously the frictional resistance are also developed. In that case it is called as combined end bearing and friction pile. So here you can see, this is the piles. These piles are rested over the hard strata. This is the basically the timber pile and this is the in-situ reinforced concrete pile. Both the piles which are rested over the hard strata, therefore end bearing piles transmit the load through their bottom tips. The ultimate bearing capacity depends upon the bearing capacity of the rock. So this is called as end bearing pile. Then the another is friction pile. You can see these piles are never reaches to the hard strata, but here the load is taken by the skin friction which is developed by the surrounding soil and it is acting over the periphery of the pile. And here there is a combined pile where the both friction as well as end bearing is acting. Then the next classification is called as classification based on mode of transfer of load. Many times, always remember that 90% piles are end bearing or the load bearing piles, where piles are used to transfer the load of the foundation over the strata. So this is called as load bearing pile. These piles are specifically used to transfer the load of the structure to a suitable strata. Then the another is compaction pile. Many times this compaction pile is the type of pile which does not carry any structural load, which is only used to improve the load carrying capacity of the area when there is a loose granular soil, and loose granular soils are very difficult to densify. In such cases, the casing is inserted. In such cases, the casing is inserted at a specified dimensions, and then that casings or that borings are filled with the sand. Then that sand is radially densify the material. This radially densify the material, and it will just take a more load. So here, these are the piles which are load bearing pile, where the load is taken by the tip resistance as well as the frictional resistance. This is the another, that is the compaction pile. This is loose granular soil which is not able to take more load. In such cases, we are inserting the piles here. The small holes are made into the soil, into the loose soil. The holes are made, and then that holes are filled with the sand, additionally filled from the top, and then it will be radially densify the material. This is the previous one. This is the next position where the soil is becomes densify, and now the whole area can take more load. But actual compaction pile does not carry any structural load, but the whole area can take load. And the third one is tension pile. These tension piles are the piles which are always in tension, means there is a load from both the sides, such as the piles which are piles which are used in a waterfront structures or lightweight structure. Here the lightweight structure which are float over the water surface, and that are anchored down with the help of a pile into the ground. But that piles are continuously in tension because there is a always uplift pressure due to the water and downward pressure due to the load. In that case, in both the sides there is a pressure, therefore that columns are called as, or that piles are called as tension pile. Then the next type of piles are the sheet pile. Sheet piles, fender pile, and anchor pile. Sheet piles mean the piles which are form a continuous wall. Fender piles and sheet piles are used for temporary purpose. Here you can see, these are the sheet piles. Basically, these sheet piles are the special type of piles which are placed side by side. These are the special type of piles which are placed side by side and form a retaining wall. Placed side by side and form a retaining wall just for the temporary structures. You can see it is act as a retaining wall which retains soil on one side and water on the another side. These are the temporary structures. Many times these type of structures are also used in the excavation purpose, where it is just installed where the purpose is solved, it is again removed and transported to another side where it is required. So these are the sheet piles. Then the third is the fender pile. You can see these are the fender piles where on the back there are sheet piles. So these type of piles are generally used for the harbors. Harbors, there is a continuous impact of the impact of ship, because over the harbor structure, here you can see these are the retaining walls or the sheet pile walls, and there is an impact of the vessels or ship on the harbor. So in that case, here these are the fender piles which are inclined piles placed after certain distance from the main structure, and that are specially used to resist the impact of the ship. That are specially used to resist the impact of the sheet so that the main structure is in a intact state. And the next one is the anchor pile. Anchor piles are the piles which are basically used for the anchor down the structure. Now the last classification is classification based on the displacement of the soil. Now just remember, if suppose this is the driven pile, this is the driven pile which is cascade over the yard. Now suppose I will install that pile into the soil. Tell me whether this installation of pile will affect the surrounding soil or not. Naturally, due to such huge material installing into the soil, the surrounding soil is getting displaced. Then it will be called as displacement pile, where all the precast piles or all the driven piles are the displaced piles. Whereas precast, or whereas cast in situ, what we are doing in the cast in situ pile, we are just making the hole. In the cast in situ pile, we are making the hole, remove the soil, and we are placing the piles. In that case, the surrounding soil is not getting displaced. In that case, it is called as non-displacement piles. I think this part of the pile foundation is clear to you all. Now, in the next class, we will just discuss how the piles are being transferred the load and how the load carrying capacity of the pile is determined.